Miami, are you ready to sing to the Lord? Come on, put your hands together like this, everybody. Hey. Let me get some more of this monitor up here, this microphone. Hey, come on. We're gonna sing to the power of the Lord comes down. Yeah, come on. You ready? I can't hear you. Are you ready to sing? Everybody, let me hear you say sing.
Till the power of the Lord comes down.
This is a worshiping church. This is a singing church. This is a church that loves the name of Jesus. Yeah. Let everything that has breath do what? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, lift those hands up all over the building. We serve an excellent God who is worthy of an excellent praise. Hallelujah. So we've come tonight. We've come to descend on Florida to give God praise, to join together as one big collective, to let the praises of God be heard. Let the nation know that Jesus saves. He heals, he delivers, and he rules. Come on, can we praise that great name? That great name, that great name. Hallelujah. Come on, oh Lord, everybody. Nobody like our God. In all of his ways, he's excellent. Come on, lift it up to the King and sing it. Is that great name? Excellent God deserves an excellent praise. We've come to lift up our voices to the King. And we want our voices not to be a sounding brass or tingling cymbal, but we wanted it to ascend to the holy hill. Hallelujah. Yes, yes, God. We're walking by faith. We're moving in this life by faith. And it's a God dream. It's an ultralight beam, but it's a God dream. Yes, it is. And it's who we are. Who are we?
We're all an ultralight beam. We're all an ultralight beam. This is a God dream. This is a God dream. This is everything.
Where are we? Put some harmony on it. We're on it. Hallelujah, it's everything.
This is everything.
We're stepping out on. Cause love is. We are. Here's the risen Lord. We're stepping out. Sometimes we call him Emmanuel. Sometimes we call him Jehovah. Father. Sometimes we call him Emmanuel.
Yeah.
Sometimes we call him Yahweh. There's many names of him. Sometimes we call him. children.
Sing
because we're going up. Lord, we're going up.
Oh. We are good.
Yeah, yeah.
We are good. We are
good. Yeah, yeah. Well, on behalf of Mr. West and the entire Sunday Service Collective, thank you for having us. We're so honored. We're so honored to be here. We're so honored to be here. We started off, we were having these services in Calabasas, California, and We started out in one location, and of course we were, that's where we were. But the media and different ones thought that we were some of everywhere. They figured we were going to Africa every week, and we had these mountains surrounding us and different things like that. But we were just right there in California all along, and we were doing Sunday service, and one Sunday, Mr. West says, yeah, my pastor is coming, he's coming, he's gonna give us a word. And I said, he was like, yeah, Pastor Rich is coming. I said, Pastor Rich? I love it when you love on your man of God like you love him here. This is a wonderful thing. And so Pastor Rich came, and he just blessed our Sunday service. He blessed our hearts. It was just tremendous. And I don't know if you know, but we got him today. He's here today. Come on, can we welcome our own, the greatest pastor? Pastor Rich Wilkinson! Woo!
How we doing Sunday service? You can take a seat for just a moment. I'm gonna preach for about 2 hours. I don't need that, bro. I'm good. Yeah. Thank you, though. No, I'm kidding. Hey, this is so very, very awesome. This is sort of like an on-the-fly plan. I hear right now there's like thousands of people out in the courtyard. Can we make some noise for all the people that are watching in the courtyard? We're sorry for the delay getting in tonight, but how many think it was worth the wait? Come on, somebody. I'm not going to talk long, but I would hate to miss this moment. This is VU Church. This is where we do church. If this is your first time gathering with us, we meet here 10 a.m., 12 p.m., 5 p.m., 7 p.m. We started in this room this morning at 5:45 a.m. Can we make some noise for every volunteer who... I don't know where my friend Kanye is. There he is right there. But I got to stop and take a moment because some of you, I don't know if you know, but Kanye and I have been on a journey for many, many years together. And I don't think I've ever gotten a moment to truly publicly honor you for, number one, the friend that you have been to me. For the last 7 years, he has been a faithful friend who has encouraged me, who's believed in me, seen things in me that I didn't see in myself, taken me all over the world, given me opportunities, opened up relationships. And I just want to make sure I take a moment tonight to publicly honor you. I know in this new season that you're in, there's sometimes a whole lot of criticism, a whole lot of opposition. I hope you know that all the people here at VU Church, we love you, we're praying for you, we have your back. And you may have some enemies in this world, but none of them are in this room tonight. And I just want to speak out loud that I believe that God is doing an incredible work in you. And I pray that you would grow in the grace of Jesus, that you'd continue to mature in your walk with him. I believe that God is lifting you up for such a time as this. And if you ever fall, guess what? You got a whole community right here that wants to help pick you back up. I love you and for you. Really quick, Mark chapter 8, we're gonna continue to sing. Can we make some noise for this choir who's been going? They did an opera. They just casually did an opera this morning and then made it to the midnight Holy Ghost service at VU Church. One little verse, Mark chapter 8, verse 34. I know there's a lot of guests here tonight, but I just wanna be as bold as I possibly can over the next 10 minutes. And so I'm gonna preach it like I feel it. These are Jesus' words. Jesus said, if anyone would come after me, he must deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. Whoever wants to save his life will lose it, but whoever wants to discover their life for this gospel, whoever loses his life for me and for this gospel will save it. What good is it for a man to gain the whole world yet forfeit his soul? I just want to take a moment really quick, and I just want to preach to you from my heart. And I simply have this phrase in my spirit tonight, no turning back. No turning back. You know, we live in an interesting day and age, don't we, that I think we live in a generation that's obsessed with falling in love. Like, it's fun to fall in love, right? Like, oh my goodness, we're in love, you know? And what's your favorite color? Red? Oh my God, me too. It's crazy. What's your favorite food? You like pizza? Oh my God, he likes pizza. Like, we just love falling in love. I remember when I first met my wife, we were 17 years of age. I was in a service like this, saw her up in a balcony like that. I was kind of newly saved, but I looked up, I said, I choose you in the name of Jesus. I remember the first time we started talking on the phone at night, it was always so funny because that puppy love, it's always hard to get off the phone. Some of you have been there before. All right, good night, you know, well, you hang up. No, shut up, you hang up. No, you hang up. No, shut up, you hang up. Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Are you still there? Yeah, I'm still there. We love falling in love, but how many of you know we have a hard time staying in love? And the problem is because we have reduced love down to a feeling. We think love is goosebumps. We think love is butterflies, but butterflies fly away. So as fast as you fall in love, you fall out of love. I believe God is looking for a generation in 2019 like never before that would declare out loud, I am not ashamed of the gospel, for I am unashamed, unafraid, unapologetic for what Jesus has done in my life. I didn't just fall in love with him, I'm staying in love with him. No turning back. Come on. God, if the world can be loud about sin, when will the church start being loud about salvation? Is there anybody in this house who would declare, I have been saved, set free, redeemed? I'm not turning back. I'm not turning back. I'm moving forward. We live in a day and age right now where the reason why many people can't see the Jesus on the inside of us. I apologize tonight if you are a person who doesn't follow Jesus. We're so grateful that you're here. You can belong here before you believe. We're so happy that you're here tonight. Come with all your questions. But sometimes us Christians, now I'm speaking to you, we live so quiet. We live so timid. We live so afraid. We live so by our feelings. And I really believe that people can't see Jesus on the inside of us because we're more addicted to getting lit than we are to being a light. See, I'm gonna take my time. See, what happens to us is that just because you feel the heat doesn't mean that you're burning. It's like, you know, if you ever go camping, which we're from Miami, so we don't do that, but when I was a little kid, I like hotels, but anyways, but when you go camping, you build a fire, and then you get as close as you possibly can. That feels good. That feels good. And then you go away from the fire. And today in 2019, that's what a lot of believers look like, is that we come to gatherings, and we come to conferences, and we come to events, and we get as close as we can to the fire, but then we run away, and we never actually jumped into the fire. We never got consumed by the fire. See, one of the scariest places you will find yourself is to think you are on fire, but come to find out you were just sensing the heat from everyone else around you. Following Jesus is not a trend. Following Jesus is a call, and it's a decision to first die that you might find real life. And tonight, with just the short amount of time that I have, I believe that Jesus is calling us. He did not come for a religion. He came to establish a long-lasting, real, vibrant relationship with you. He loves you. He has a plan for you. But it was Jesus who said, if you come and follow me, you must deny yourself, pick up your cross. You must die that you might find life. What does it profit a man to gain the whole world but forfeit his soul? And tonight, I wonder if you're in this room, if you're in this place, maybe you have come to a place that you think that you can, with your money, purchase your soul. You can't. You think with your status, you can purchase your soul. You can't. Your fame can't purchase your soul. Your education can't purchase your soul. There is only one who satisfies your soul, and it's the same one who purchased your soul. His name is Jesus Christ. Come on, somebody, give him praise in this place. Phil, can you give me some keys? I'm a close, but if you don't start playing keyboards, I'll just teach forever. So just put me in my close mode. Otherwise, I'll just go all night long and people waited too long. I love you. Tonight, Jesus is calling you into a real relationship. And you have to decide in this place, beyond the hype, beyond the feeling, beyond the shouting, you have to decide, do you want to encounter him? Who is Jesus to you? Because he's one of three things. He's either a liar, he's either a lunatic, or he is Lord. Jesus is not a shout out at an award show. Jesus is not a piece of jewelry you wear around your neck. He's not a part of your life. He's either all of your life or he's nothing at all. And friend, he loves you. And your soul will never, ever find peace and rest until you surrender to the one who picked you and chose you and loves you. And tonight, he is the Lord of all. And the men who spread this message, they didn't just die figuratively. They actually literally died. They gave their life to follow Jesus. See, make no mistake about it. This movement, this thing called Christianity, following Jesus, it has not moved forward from success to success. It has moved forward from sacrifice to sacrifice on the blood, sweat, and tears of men and women who would say, this thing is so good, it's worth dying for. And tonight, if Jesus is Lord, then he deserves much more than just a morally decent life. He deserves that you would fall on your knees and cry out, save me. Save me. That's my prayer tonight, that if you walked in here, maybe you've tried everything in this world, but have you tried Jesus? Because tonight, if you'll surrender your life to Jesus and declare there's no turning back, the cross before me, the world behind me, I'm telling you what, you're gonna find a peace that surpasses all understanding. You ever just take time to think about how incredible Jesus is? Even if you're a doubter, even if you don't believe he's God, just think about it. There has never been anybody in history quite like him. I mean, how did this guy with 12 dudes who were not educated, farmers and tax collectors, how together did they spread a movement that now spans the world? You know that Jesus, he never wrote a song, but there's more songs written about Jesus than any other person in the world. Jesus never wrote a book, but there's more books written about Jesus than anybody in the world. To my knowledge, Jesus wasn't an artist. He didn't build statues. He didn't mold, but rather there is more art dedicated to this man than any person in the entire world. I mean, for goodness sakes, you don't believe in Jesus? Okay. You can't tell time without him. What year is it? 2019 AD, Anno Domini, in the year of our Lord Jesus Christ. You don't even know what time it is without recognizing Jesus. He split the calendar. You say, how did all this happen? It didn't happen because of good principles and good teaching and good morals. It happened because there was a man named Jesus who said, if you follow me, I will give you life. And then all of a sudden he went to a cross to take the place for your sins and for my sins. And he was crucified on that day and he was buried in a tomb. People watched him die. And when they watched him die, there were no followers of Jesus at the cross. They scattered. Because messiahs don't die and sons of God can't be killed. And so they said, this must not be the one. Oh, but friends, 3 days later, I said 3 days later, Jesus Christ resurrected from the grave. The way this faith has moved forward is based upon an event that a man died and he resurrected. And if he really resurrected, you have to consider maybe, just maybe, he actually is Lord. Today he's alive. And this is what separates him from every other man and every other God who ever came before him. For literally, friends, tonight, we could go to the grave of some great men in the past, but you'd have to be quiet, you'd have to be silent, because their bones are buried there. Oh, friends, you could go over to the grave of some great teachers, but shh, show reverence, be quiet, their bones are buried there. You could go to the grave of some great faith teachers who did some good stuff, but when you get there, shh, hush, hush, the bones are buried there. This is reverent ground. But I got good news for you, Sunday service. You can rock up to the tomb of Jesus Christ with your Yeezys on. And you don't have to be quiet, but rather you can open up your mouth and you can give a shout of praise. Because guess what? He's not there. He's alive. King of kings, Lord of lords, Alpha and Omega. He rose. You don't believe in him, he believes in you. And Jesus says, I'm the way, I'm the truth, I'm the life. No one comes to the Father but through me. He's not trying to be exclusive, he's trying to be specific. He loves you. And he has a plan for you tonight. He says, come, follow me. In order to follow, I gotta die so that I might be resurrected in him. But what does it profit a man to gain the whole world but forfeit his soul? Tonight, all over this place, would you stand to your feet? In a moment, we're going to worship. In a moment, we're going to give God some praise. But I feel like tonight is a night for so many people. Those that don't know Jesus, I want to give you an opportunity here tonight to put your trust in him. Those of you that have been following Jesus, this is a night to draw a line in the sand to say, no turning back. I didn't just fall in love with Jesus. I'm staying in love with Jesus. I'm going to play my part, and I'm going to make sure this whole world knows that Jesus is King. Your head's bowed, your eyes are closed. There's no one looking around. If you're here tonight, you'd say, Rich, that's me. My life is not right with God. Would you just check your soul for a moment? Would you just see how you're doing on the inside? Tonight's a good night to surrender. You're in a room full of faith. You're sensing the heat. That's people's faith. But tonight, why don't you let the God who's known as the all-consuming fire, why don't you let him light your life on fire? He doesn't just want you to burn. He wants you to shine bright. Your head's bowed, your eyes are closed. If you're in this room and you never surrendered your life to Jesus, would you be bold tonight? Would you say, Rich, that's me. You're talking to me, Rich. Tonight, I want to make Jesus the Lord of my life. I want to surrender. I want to declare out loud in front of this company of witnesses that Jesus is King. If that's you, would you be bold and on the count of three? Would you just lift your hand up high enough and long enough just so I can see it? I want to include you in this prayer of salvation. I love our church because every Sunday at this point, hands start going up and it's happening right now. Even before I count to three, people saying, that's me, Rich, that's me. I wanna surrender my life to Jesus. Ready, one, the Bible says today is the day of salvation. Don't put it off towards next Sunday. This is your moment, this is your hour right now. No turning back. Two, don't look at your neighbor, forget about your neighbor. This is a moment between you and Jesus. Ready, one, two, three. If that's you, just lift it up, that's me, that's me. That's me, Rich. That's me. That's me. That's me. That's me. That's me. Hands going up all over the room tonight. VU Church, Sunday service, can we all lift our hands towards heaven together? Can we pray this prayer out loud with everything we've got? Scripture says, believe in your heart, confess with your mouth, and you shall be saved. You can't achieve Jesus. You receive him. It's a free gift. He loves you just the way that you are. Oh, but friend, he loves you too much to let you stay the way that you are. Tonight, he's bringing you on a journey. Pray this out loud. Say, dear Jesus, tonight I surrender. I give you my life. Forgive me of all my sin. I repent. I give you my past. I give you my present. I even place my future in your hands. I'm yours, Jesus. Tonight I believe, God, that you have a good plan for me. So I choose to follow you, for I believe that you are God. Tonight, Lord, help me follow you. Tonight I declare, no turning back. I love you. Come on, church, can we go ahead and celebrate every person who just prayed that prayer? Oh, come on, can we make a little bit more noise than that? Let's go ahead and celebrate every person tonight.
To fix you.
is right here. Come on, can we give God a praise for the great word that came from the man of God? Turn to your neighbor and say, I'm not going back. Come on, say it like you believe it. I'm not going back. There's nothing out there for me. I'm going with Christ all the way. No turning back, no turning back. Hallelujah. The world behind me, the cross is in front of me. And every day may not be perfect, but with God, I'm on the perfect path. And He is my Redeemer, and I'm saved and I'm delivered because of Him, because of what He has done. Can we give God a praise for the Word, for the Word, for the Word? The Word, the Word. Jesus says, for the hour is coming when the true worship would worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father is... He's seeking, he's looking for us, those that would worship Him. Are there any worshipers? Come on, just lift your hands. Let's lift them up. Let's lift them up to Him. And just right where you are, just open your mouth and just make an altar right there. Come on, come on, come on. Father, we love you. Come on, just let it flow from your mouth. Come on, Voo Church. Come on, come on. Come on, turn the volume up on that great praise. He wants to hear you talk to Him. He wants to hear you sing to Him. Hallelujah. Nobody like our God. Sweep over this place, Father. We need a touch. We need provision. We need a Savior. Hallelujah. We need you. We need you. We need you. We want you. We want you. Come and fill our hearts again. Come and sweep over our soul again. Hallelujah. Clean us up, wash us. Come on, collective, give Him the highest praise. Sing it to Him. Hallelujah. Come on, say it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Salvation and glory.
Salvation and glory.
Honor and power.
Honor and power unto the Lord our God.
For the Lord our God is mighty.
For the Lord our God is mighty.
Lord our God is omnipotent.
Yes, the Lord our God is omnipotent.
Come on, call Him the Lord. Come on, altos. Come on, testify.
Oh, praises be to the King of peace and the Lord our God. He is wonderful.
Sing it again, oh, praise. That's it. Come on, sing with the Miami. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
heaven's gate. I ain't gotta peek over. Keep it perfect composure when I scream at the chauffeur. I ain't mean, I just focus. Put a lean out slower. Got us clean out of soda. Before the flood, people judge. They did the same thing to Noah. Everybody wanted Yanni. And Jesus Christ did the laundry. They said the week start on Monday, but the strong start on Sunday. Won't be in bondage to any man. John. We the descendants of Abraham. Yea, shall be made free. John 8:33. To whom the Son set free is free indeed. He said, a wretch like me. He could save someone like me. He could save a wretch like me. He could set you free. Set you free. He said a wretch like me. He said a wretch like me. He said a wretch like me. He said a wretch like me.
Stretch my hands to you.
Set on my heart to start a church, and that's what I called it, even though there was Christians that told me, you can't call it that, you ain't got no pastor, so you can't call it a church. I said, whatever it's called, is somebody calling me.
Come on, yeah, yeah.
Y'all get all into the semantics. It's a feeling that it was something more powerful than anything, entertainment, money, fame, clout, social media, something more powerful than it all. Something that can bring us all together. Jesus has already won the victory. And then I surrounded myself with the most beautiful rehab, fame rehab, ego rehab possible. People singing to the one and only Lord Jesus Christ every weekend. And 4 months in, I was delivered. And I didn't know what to do at that point. I didn't know if I couldn't laugh at the same jokes. Because my jokes was real un-Christ-like, you know? And the things I would laugh at, things I would rap about. And I even thought, like, I don't even know if I should rap again. And I remember a friend of mine, Pastor Adam, by the studio one day. He had his kid, and he said something really that impacted me. He said, my son said, I just want a yay rap album about Jesus. Like, the devil had rap music so wrapped up, I thought I couldn't rap and serve God at the same time. Then I had friends that, oh, you could, hold on, give me a mic that ain't doing that.
Yeah.
Yeah. My hands to you. Is there something about the position where I'm standing where it's doing that? I must have to come up here then. Stretch my hand. Father, I stretch my hand. Stretch my hands to you. I stretch. So I had a friend of mine that was like, so you could do all that rapping for the devil, but now that you're serving God, you can't, your voice and use your anointing to rap. Then I would play some of the music I was playing, and it was some rapper friends I had come over. Of course, they'd play their songs, and it'd just be like, I can't say what it's saying. In this environment, I'm not gonna repeat what it said. What every single song said, back to back to back to back to back to back to back. And then they looking at me like, hey boy, fall off with all that. And it's so funny when you look up, to God be the glory, Jesus King be number one on all forms. Three weeks in a row, follow God number one on Hot 100. Also, I thought, is this all gonna fall off following God? Now, I ain't saying that it's easy, saved. And this is one of my favorite things. When somebody don't be saved and you get mad about something you're supposed to be mad about, you ain't got to be right to be mad. You Christian. That ain't God-like. Oh, so you think that just Christian, we just roll over for the devil, huh? No, that ain't it. We gonna pray for grace. Hands to you, Father, I stretch my hand.
Stretch my hands to you.
You know, it's an accountability and a responsibility that I take on in my position in the middle of so many idols. As a married Christian father. Father, I stretch my hand. Father, stretch my hand. I know this is not the best example, but since we did Mary today in the opera, I gotta say that when this fell upon me, I keep on saying, I feel like a teenage mom or something. I feel like I gotta be the grandmother, the grandfather, the father, the mother, in so many situations where I couldn't even look around. I didn't have no friends that was Christian in my position. Y'all ever been in that situation where you the only one saved and everyone looking at you like you so crazy? Stretch my hands to you.
Father, I stretch.
Stretch my hands to you.
Stretch my hands to you.
Here's another one I bet y'all struggle with right here. How many times somebody try to tell you, you judging somebody just because you holding them accountable? Devil try to have us shook out here. We can't go left, we can't go right. If you bring it up, why are you judging me? Then they be at the Golden Gates talking about, where my name? Why you ain't tell me? I'd rather tell you. That's one thing where God is going to use my personality. He got somebody that's going to say something all the time. Father, I stretch my hands to you. Father, I stretch my hand. Father, I stretch my hand. Lord God, thank you so much for Pastor Rich. I know Pastor Rich had to deal with about 5-6 years of people coming up to him every day like, what's up with your boy? So you can tell him today, Pastor, this is what's up with my boy now. Pray without cease. Na, 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 na. You know where we at. We are closed on Sunday. Why? We closed. Cause. Oh, the selfies. Put the gram away. Get your family. Y'all hold hands and pray. When you got daughters, always keep them safe. Shout for vipers. Don't let them indoctrinate. Closed on Sunday. Why? You're my. With the what? Raise our sons. Train them in the faith. Through temptations. Make sure they're wide awake. Follow Jesus. Listen and obey. No more living for the culture, we nobody slave. Even if I take this walk up, I bow down to the king upon the.
Hallelujah!
Put your hands together. Come on. Come on, like this. Come on. Come on, let's go. Oh. nations rejoice. Hallelujah. God is good. Hallelujah. And that's just how the good Lord works. Come on, can we make one big choir? Come on, rock with us. Hey. Come on. I see you out there. Come on. Here we go. Ooh, everybody. That's it. That's it. Say it again. Ha. What you got to say?
That's how he works. That's how the good Lord he works.
That's how he works.
That's how he works.
That's how.
That's how
the good Lord.
The good Lord he works.
Everybody, put your hands together. That's
for a couple days. I could have just calmly been like, the power belongs to God. But now I gotta sing in a different register. The power belongs to God. The power belongs to God. There is nothing to
God. There is nothing to hide.
For my sins, but you probably take away from my ends. I know it take away from my sins. Bring the day that I'm dreaming about. Next time I'm in the club, everybody screaming out. God showed me the way, cause the devil tried to break me down. The only thing that I prayed is that my feet didn't fail me now. And I know exactly what I gotta do to right my wrong. I wanna talk to God, I ain't afraid no more.
We ain't afraid no more. We ain't afraid no more. We ain't afraid no more. We ain't afraid no more. We ain't afraid.
We ain't afraid to be specific, to say his name, the one and only Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. We ain't afraid to say his name. Jesus has won the victory. We ain't afraid no more. Only fear God. And we ain't afraid of nothing else. When King Nebuchadnezzar tried to make Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego eat the food, We ain't eating your food. We ain't bowing to your statue. We know that our God is gonna deliver us. And even if our God don't come right now, we still ain't bowing. We ain't afraid no more. We ain't afraid. 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 God holds higher. Jesus holds higher than any media out there.